Have you ever wondered how your phone charger efficiently delivers power, or how your car's ignition system knows when to spark? You might be surprised to learn that one crucial component behind all these is something called an inductor. Today, on Engineeringness, we're diving into everything you need to know about inductors. In the early 19th century, scientists like Michael Faraday in England and Joseph Henry in America were experimenting with electricity and magnetism. Their groundbreaking work gave us inductors, devices that can store energy in a magnetic field. 1831, Faraday's law of induction, England. 1832, Joseph Henry's electromagnetic discoveries, USA. 1900s, industrial usage of inductors in radios and power grids. Modern day, inductors in virtually all electronic devices. But what exactly is an inductor and how does it work? An inductor is essentially a coil of wire that stores energy in a magnetic field and helps regulate current fluctuations. They usually consist of a wire wound round a ferromagnetic core. Voltage across an inductor gives rise to a magnetic field. If the current changes, the inductor resists that change by inducing a voltage in the opposite direction, also known as opposite polarity. This is explained by Faraday's law and Lenz's law. This can be shown in the following equation. If we consider sign conventions, we often write V equals minus LDI over DT. To emphasize that the polarity of the induced voltage opposes the change in current. This property is why inductors are commonly used to smooth out electrical signals or filter unwanted high-frequency noise in circuits. They resist rapid changes in current, helping to stabilize or shape voltage and current waveforms. We can visualize the way an inductor works by looking at an inductor in a circuit parallel to a lamp, which can act as a resistive load. When we apply a current to the circuit, the current will first flow through the lamp, powering it up. Little to no current will flow through the inductor as the resistance is too large. The current takes the path of least resistance. However, as time passes, the resistance will be reduced, leading to it becoming the preferred route for the current, eventually causing the bulb to turn off. If we then disconnect the power source, the inductor will continue to push the current through the bulb until the resistance dissipates most of the energy remaining. Before we dive into the anatomy of an inductor, if you're enjoying this deep dive into the world of electronic components, don't forget to subscribe to Engineeringness and give us a thumbs up. We've got plenty more tech explorations to come. Also, check our online store for unique engineering products and help us keep making awesome content. It really helps us out a lot. Link down below. The anatomy of an inductor. Let's break down the basic parts of an inductor. Coil, winding, the wire, often copper, wrapped in multiple turns to increase inductance. Core material. This can differ depending on the inductor and its applications. Some inductors have an air core, while others use ferromagnetic materials, like iron or ferrite, to boost the magnetic field. Leads or terminals, the point of connection to the external circuit. The amount of inductance depends on factors like the number of turns, N, core permeability, and the coil's geometry. This is shown in the following equation, where equals permeability of the core material, N equals number of turns in the coil, A equals cross-sectional area of the coil, L equals length of the coil. Right-hand rule, determining magnetic field direction. Just like with magnets, you can use the right-hand rule to figure out the direction of the magnetic field around the inductor. Point your thumb in the direction of the current through the coil. Your curled fingers show the direction of the magnetic field lines. Inside the coil, the magnetic field lines run along the axis of the inductor. Types of inductors. Air core inductors. No solid core, just air, used at high frequencies in radio antennas. Lightweight and easy to produce, but lower inductance. Iron core and ferrite core inductors. Higher permeability materials increase inductance, common in power supplies and audio equipment. Provide excellent filtering capabilities. Toroidal inductors, donut-shaped core, reduce electromagnetic interference because the magnetic field is mostly contained within the toroid. Chokes, special inductors designed to block or choke high-frequency noise in circuits, common in power lines and electronic filters. Inductors are everywhere in modern technology. power supplies, where inductors smooth out current and voltage fluctuations. Radio communications, inductors form tuning circuits along with capacitors. Automotive systems, ignition coils rely on inductors to generate high voltages for spark plugs. Wireless chargers, coils in the charger and the device, use mutual inductance to transfer power. From filtering out noise in power supplies to enabling wireless charging, inductors play a quiet but crucial role in modern electronics. Next time you see a coil on a circuit board, you'll know it's not just a random spiral of wire. It's a powerhouse of magnetic energy storage. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, be sure to like, share, and subscribe to Engineeringness. Stay curious and never stop exploring the incredible world of science and engineering.